So if you're like me, you work on several different languages, framework, UI libraries, other type of random tools or languages from your day to day. And because of that, your Visual Studio Code extensions are going to look like a cluttered closet full of different extensions for all the tools that you use. But what if I told you that there's a better way to manage all of that, and it's coming soon? Let's check out Visual Studio Code's new and upcoming feature, multiple profiles. So the VS Code team is working on a new iteration of how they handle profiles. Now you'll be able to create different profiles that install different extensions, shortcuts, and settings for the different environments that you're going to work in. So let's check it out. So if you want to install Visual Studio Code Insiders, just visit the Visual Studio Code website. And by default, you're given a nice big button to download the current build for standard. But all you have to do is click on the drop down here, and you can see the option for Insiders. So you would just install the corresponding build for your operating system and just click it, and you're good to go. And the nice thing is you don't have to worry about having a Visual Studio Code installed and Visual Studio Code Insiders installed. They both play nice together, so you can have them both on there. So if you wanted to experiment with Visual Studio Code Insiders, you don't have to worry about it messing with your Visual Studio Code. If we take a look over at the extension section, you can see I have 83 different extensions installed. Extensions for install it for managing Azure, HAML, we have Docker, Elixir, JavaScript ESLint stuff, Forget, JavaScript, Lua, and Phoenix Framework, so, and Ruby. We can see that I have a lot of different extensions for all the different projects, for all the different languages that I use. And it's pretty crazy because I don't need all of this for my React project. So in order to use profiles, go to the bottom left and you're going to see this new kind of like slider thing. So by default, it's using the standard user profile that is defines you this whole time in VS Code. But we can go in here and click create profile. And you have two options. You can create an empty profile or you can create from a current profile. The way I like to use this is I just create from a current profile and let's just call this the JavaScript profile. And now we have our JavaScript profile and we can choose an icon that we want to use for this. So let's just do the light bulb. So after you create your profile, it will do a little refresh, but now we will see that the icon on the bottom left is a light bulb. And actually we can see right here on the top that it's actually saying JavaScript. So it's telling us what our profile is. So if we click on that, it'll look almost the same thing, but now we have a couple options to change the icon, change the name, show the contents, but now we can get to customizing our profile. So now that we're in here, everything that we do in here is going to be saved to this profile. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna nix out everything that doesn't matter for JavaScript. So you just go through the standard workflow for yourself is just uninstall. Like we don't have to disable for this project, for this workspace. You can just do a straight uninstall because it's not going to be uninstalled from the default one. It's only being uninstalled for the profile that you're currently on. So let's just go through here and just start removing a bunch of different extensions. All right, so we went through and we just did a quick pass on here. And we removed a bunch of extensions. We went from 83 to 63. There's still a lot more we can go through, but there's only so much of time that I want to fast forward through this video. So we have 63, and I just basically removed all the extensions for Ruby and Elixir because we're inside a React JavaScript project. So let's take a look at and see, and let's switch our profiles. If you click on the icon on the bottom left again, that's where you can switch your profiles. So let's go ahead and click default. So we can switch over to our default profile and see what happens. So we swap over again, it does a complete refresh, and now you can see that we have 83 different extensions installed again. Let's go back to JavaScript and we swap over, and now it's reinitialized and we only have 63 extensions installed. And the added benefit, as I mentioned before, is not only can you customize the different extensions you have installed on the project, but also it remembers the shortcuts and everything. The other cool enhancements in here too is you can easily share stuff. So we can export our profile and we could choose all the settings that we want to export with the profile, all the UI settings, all the type of stuff for a standard profile. And we can actually generate a GitHub gist off of this so that we could provide it to someone else so they can easily download it. So if you wanted to share it with other people in your company or just share it with other people on the internet, you can do that. And it's just that easy to now have separate profiles for your different projects. So the other thing I was talking about, separate profiles for your different projects, is that it actually remembers the profiles you've chosen for your project. So let's quickly switch over to another project that is an Elixir project, and let's see what happens. So we swapped over, and now we're switched to the default profile. I can go through here and I can create a custom one for Elixir, so we only initialize the extensions for Elixir. But what I want to just quickly do is let's swap back over to the React project. And you can see, because we had chosen a specific profile for our project, it had automatically launched the project with that profile specified. Really cool, really cool. And also your profiles are synchronized if you have Setting Sync on. So if you've logged in and you turn on Setting Sync with your GitHub account or your Microsoft account so that you could save your settings to the cloud if you run VS Code on different machines, or if you use CodeSpaces, that is synchronized too. So regardless of where you go, your profiles go with you. So if you want to give this a try, again, it is currently on the Visual Studio Code Insiders builds. So you'll have to go over to the Visual Studio Code website for installation and choose the Insiders build.